Hello everyone, welcome back to the show, and today we're gonna talk about the measures which RBI has taken to spur the economy. So there has been a deep cut in the interest rate and they have released some 3,74,000 crore for the economy boost. So these are some measures which RBI has released, and this particular infograph has been picked up from Times of India. They have cut down the repo rate by 75 BPS points. So when the repo rate is being cut by 75 BPS to 4.40%, while the reverse repo rate was cut by 90 BPS to 4%. So this particular measure helps the RBI and the government to push liquidity into the ecosystem, because now it will be so the banks. So I'll give you the basic funda behind the repo rate and the reverse repo rate. So what happens is banks can deposit with RBI for a particular interest rate, and banks they can take the money from RBI at a particular interest rate. So both of these interest rates are being reduced, which makes sure that it's not it's not very attractive for the banks to keep the money with the RBI. That's why they will they will use these funds to give it to the productive sectors of the economy. Another effort which was made by the RBI is that they have reduced cash reserve ratios by 100 BPS points. That's another liquidity adjustment facility which RBI has taken. Measures were taken for the people of India. So the first step which government has taken is they have allowed for the deferment of the interest on working capital facilities. So this will help the businesses out there to not pay the interest rate. And when I say I'm not saying not pay the interest rate, this is deferment. So what deferment means is that you are allowed to not pay the EMI for next 3 months, but as soon as these 3 months deferment or moratorium period completes, you have to start paying that particular EMI. So it's not that you won't have to pay these EMIs, it's just that you have gotten 3 months period to not pay these EMIs, and the loan period which was so for example your loan period was till December 2020, so it will increase by 3 months till March end 2020. So the loan period which was given to you will increase by 3 months, and this particular interest and principal payment which you were supposed to make during this period will be deferred, and you can start paying it after 3 months. So March 1st is when this will be applicable, and so March, April, May, so you will start paying it from June. And December was the ending period for your loan, so it will increase till March. So that's how it will work. Apart from that, there is also moratorium on the term loans. Term loans can be any kind of loans, home loans, car loans, and even durable loans will come under it. We'll deep dive into it. I'm just giving you a gist that what has been done. And there is also the easing of working capital facilities, which was done by RBI to make sure that the funds are easily available. Though there is a lot of liquidity in the ecosystem, people are taking out their money from the stock market, because stock market is anyways crashing, but we have seen some good days in last 2-3 days. Coming back to the point where some of the bankers said that RBI intervention will solve the supply chain side problems, but we will still have to see how the demand will pick up as soon as period of lockdown gets over. So demand is really important for the economy to pick up. That we all know that the demand and the supply side has to match up. The working capital cycle will be extended, which I talked about it. So now bank can reassess the working capital, and it won't be considered as a restructuring and downgrade of your loan. So just the period of the loan will increase. Let's deep dive. So let's say your EMI is pending by on March 31st. So what do you have to do? You don't have to do anything, as this particular moratorium or deferment has been applied from March 1st. So you can actually not pay this EMI, and you can start paying these EMI from June onwards. So March, April, May, 3 months moratorium deferment period is given, and from June onwards you can start paying these EMIs. Will the payment be deducted from your account? It can be, because there is a lien being placed on your account, but now it's up to the bank, because now the policy has been given by RBI. So what happens is when RBI has come out with a policy, the banks have to decide that how they have to approve these things. Definitely the lien would be placed and it can be deducted, but you can talk to your respective bank customer executives to not deduct this particular amount. So will non-payment of your EMI will affect your credit score? I don't think so, because this is a deferment which is given by the RBI and all the rating agencies. Then we come to the which banks are allowed to give this deferment period benefit. All of the banks, all the financial institutions like NBFCs, cooperative banks, local area banks, small finance banks, regional rural banks, all commercial banks are allowed to give this deferment periods. Even housing finance companies, microfinance institutions are included in this list. So is another important point which I think you all might have a doubt about, that is it a waiver or a deferment of EMI? So it's definitely a deferment. I have been using this term from the starting of the episode. So deferment means that you won't have to pay these EMIs for these 3 months. You have to pay these EMIs after these 3 months complete, and as soon as these 3 months will be completed, you can start paying your EMIs, and your loan period, which was for example, which was till December, will increase to March. So you will not be penalized for any of this. So does this mean I have to pay all the EMIs from June onwards? No, you don't have to pay all the EMIs from June onwards. You can pay it per month. So you were supposed to pay EMI on March 31st. The same EMI you have to pay on June 30th. So for example, let's say you were supposed to pay 10,000 bucks at the end of the month of March. So now those 10,000 bucks is what you have to pay in June, and then going forward it will continue. So you don't have to pay 30,000 bucks altogether in June. You can pay it month wise. Another important thing that this moratorium period covers principal and interest both. Yes, it covers both interest and principal. So let's say 80% of the loan amount, loan EMI is always interest, and 20% is what is the principal. So both are included in this deferment period. What kind of loans are covered in this moratorium period? RBI policy statement explicitly mentions loans, including agriculture term loans, crop loan insurance, and beside other retail loans. So retail loans can be home loan, personal loan, education loan, auto loans, and any loans that have a fixed tenure. So the term loan which has a fixed tenure, so personal loan also has a fixed tenure of 3 years, 5 years, so that also has been given a deferment. Also include those consumer durable loans, EMI on mobiles and other things, or EMI on TV and other things. Coming back to the next point, does it apply to credit card? Yes, it does apply to the credit card also. So the loans taken over credit card is something which is not specifically mentioned in the RBI policy statement, but we assume that as credit cards are covered, the loans taken over these credit cards are also will also be covered. But you can get in touch with your branch or your customer executive to know more about it. If you have taken any project loan or something like that to build up a factory or something, is that covered? No, RBI guidelines specifically mentioned only retail loans, so a business loan is unlikely to qualify. And what are some steps taken by the RBI for the businesses? So these deferment period also applies for the working capital loans taken by the businesses. So working capital loan is something which is given to businesses basic the revenue they are generating over months. So what banks have to do is recalculate these working capital requirements by these businesses and how they would be affected by this particular lockdown period or the coronavirus effect, and then accordingly the accumulated interest for the period will be paid after the expiry of the deferment period. Moratorium will be treated as a moratorium or deferment period will not be treated as change in terms and conditions of loan agreements and will not result in asset classification downgrade. That's another benefit which businesses will get. So whatever effect you have in these 3 months on your businesses, it will not lead to downgrade of your working capital or something like that, because businesses, as you know, that working capital loan is something where the banks have to recalculate the working capital loan every year, and that's like they calculate how depending on how you did around the year, and accordingly they make they decide that you will keep getting this working capital loan for the next year also. But as per RBI, these 3 months are not going to affect or downgrade your working capital requirements. We might have to see how after this lockdown the demand rises. We hope for the best. Stay indoors, stay with your family, don't go out, stay safe. Let's fight against this coronavirus. Have a great day ahead.